This is it. We are getting into the first game of the day with the round two of the Swedish Championships of Quake Live between Empish and Z4muz. And I've got to say right off the beginning, I want to watch a bit of Z4muz. He's getting that top yellow spawn onto Rockets, onto Mega. He can get himself another yellow if he wishes. He's going to need to start hunting down those weapons. It looks like the rail will be his second go-to gun.
I mean, obviously, since Z4muz doesn't know the new maps really well, Empish will have a very good chance of winning this map and the third map, which should be Cure. So I think in the start, Empish should have tried to play a little bit more aggressive, because now Z4muz is fairly comfortable after eating those rails. Z4muz will also not know all the rail angles, so this is something Empish could try to
advantage on. We could have first blood right here. Empish has got red armor, but he is stuck in a corner, and Z4muz will get first blood. Misses the rail right off the spawn. But certainly a start that Z4muz would have been very much hoping for on a map that, as you said, doesn't favor him too much.
Only because he doesn't know it that well yet. Because with the style he has, he can just become a beast in every map. I think the last map I played with him was actually this one, and he wasn't bad at all.
Oh really? You played him here?
Yeah.
I see. He managed to get a pretty clean red, now going up through the LG, taking a bit of damage. Good output here from Empish. And he's actually taking barely any damage himself, but here it is, lightning gun coming out, and Empish immediately evacuating the area. Mega and red up at the same time, so this is a chance for Empish to get the red armor if he's quick. It might already be too late right now.
Oh,
he'll take the red.
Empish.
Overkill right here.
Yeah. Overkill indeed, and Zempus.
Really having trouble today, my co-commentator.
Oh my.
He's been quite quiet. He looks very relaxed, I gotta say.
He looks relaxed because he's not really branching out of his comfort zone as far as movement goes. He's just doing his own thing, not really caring about anything else.
Oh, good rails here from Empish. He manages to string two together, doesn't hit one after, and Z4muz finally gets a bit of revenge.
Yeah, but now it's gonna be bad for Empish, because after all of the damage they traded, Empish can't really do much. Very good damage on Empish right here. If he bounces, Z4muz can try and steal the mag himself. This is what he's looking for, but
good counter moves, yeah.
Really good counter move indeed.
And that should be a top yellow for Empish. Z4muz getting quite weak. One rail would totally cripple him. And I think Z4muz recognizes, okay, red's up. I can go over to my little land of safety now. And now
he
can continue.
He's so alive, thought, in the way that he moves and the way that he fights.
Oh, here's a right rocket. And a rail to follow up. Z4muz might be in trouble once again. But Empish can't seem to do the damage right at the end. Two rails back to back. And Z4muz gets his fourth kill. We're barely 3 minutes in, man. Look, it's such a low-scoring game.
Yeah, that was like very, very good damage by Empish, but then when he had to actually clutch it, he could have just gone forward with the LG, but he wanted another rail. He comes aggressive again, but he's gonna have to back away, and Z4muz, he can just rocket jump and get the 50 HP. Does he even need it, though? He's gonna check now that Empish probably took the 225s if they were there.
Yeah,
50 HP is still
up.
So Z4muz not really getting that much emphasis on it, but he knows it's there for whenever he wants to take it. There he goes.
He just waddles over to it, man. He's in no rush, it seems. And he's just waiting. He's looking for information, waiting for Empish to make the next move. Finds him! Direct rocket! A bit of splash damage at the end. And that's one more. That's some kind of vicious snake at the moment. He looks relaxed, but for any fraction of a second, he can just pounce on you and completely destroy your hopes and dreams. Decent rockets, a bit of lightning gun at the end. Empish is going to be pretty weak right now. Oh, the rock is 10 health! There we go. Empish is so low at the end of that, but he's on the board and will be delighted by this.
That's a lot of LG damage from Empish. Can he take the frag?
Oh.
He does. 9 health. He cannot rocket jump.
Two bullets would have killed him. He managed to avoid it. He's running away. The lightning gun coming towards him. Z4muz is going to shave that health off of him. 5-2. There's the mega. And he's managed to acquire a decent stack after that kill. Which is sad, because if Empish got the kill, he would have had that. And he could have been tying the game up very soon.
Yeah, but Empish was really expecting Z4muz not to have any weapon off the spawn.
200, man.
Well,
bit of rocket damage coming over, jumps over that one. And Empish, he's just looking for damage. Can't really fault what he's trying to do, but he needed a bit more then to make it worth it.
Getting damage now, in 5 seconds before the mag, if he spawns in the LG, let's see if he's gonna make a push for it, or if he's just gonna try to get the rails. No, Z4muz is gonna be the one finding him, actually.
Oh, dude, Empish is appearing right behind him. There's gonna be the mega steal. Z4muz is on red. We've actually getting the rocket jump up, almost intercepted. Azama's back down to the bottom. He's in the acid. Great move by Empish. Quick thinking there, earning him his third kill.
Oh, unfortunately, to get the rail off the spawn, and Z4muz can attack at his yellow. Oh my.
That was very close, man. In the end, neither player got that yellow armor, and if one of them did, they probably would have been the one to survive. Yeah, oh, the plasma. Rocket's even
racking up the kills now. And it's only a 3-frag game now.
Mm-hmm. Red has been taken by Z4muz. Mega gonna be up at this point. And Empish, he's stacked up. He knows he's got plenty of time. He can just try and minimize any kind of errors.
Empish just lets Z4muz get the rail and the LG. And he doesn't have a rail himself, so he's gonna need to be really, really careful now.
He's being pretty damn careful, I gotta say. He's being very
quiet.
Oh my god! Please, can we upload the frag movie now? That was absolutely immense.
Yeah.
I can't even think of the right word to describe it. That was phenomenal, man. Let's see if he can use that to carry a bit of momentum and start getting towards those 8 frags that Z4muz currently has.
No Z4muz around. I think he heard the top yellow getting taken. He needs to start doing damage onto Z4muz. Okay, it's enough damage. He can either get the frag now or get to the red.
Where's Z4muz? Is he still over the LG?
Right below him.
There
he is.
Wow.
Good read. But Z4muz's damage is just so high.
It's insane.
Yeah. Empish needs to stack up again, because now Z4muz doesn't really have anything. That's the good part. Now he needs one yellow, and Z4muz probably have another yellow.
Yeah, actually one yellow being taken by Z4muz just there. Empish trying to cut him off somewhere. He's found him with a lightning gun. This could be frag number 7. Mega up in a moment. Empish
Mega
is going towards yellow.
Z4muz didn't see the Mega though.
Oh dude, this is going to be a tied game right here. Z4muz can't even hit the rail. There's the red. Empish, he's going to surely zoom over to the Mega health now. Z4muz won't...
Mega.
Oh, he is going to jump on it.
Oh, and Z4muz is already doing a lot of damage.
Empish has got to work completely overtime at this point. He needs to push the pressure onto Z4muz even more and try and swipe away a lead.
There's a yellow up. He needs it. He knows that he's taking a lot of time. He doesn't know where Z4muz is, and now Z4muz can try to steal the red. Empish needs to make an attack. He needs to do a lot of damage. He's doing
not much. That was maybe 20 damage tops.
Yeah, and now Z4muz is starting to connect with the rails. The mag is going to be up. Is Z4muz going to try to attack? It should be a very good attack, and good rocket by Z4muz.
Oh, more air rockets? Not yet from Empish. He's getting some rockets here. 13 health left. Z4muz, is he going to be around? Well, I don't know what corner he's going to be around, but surely he knows that Empish
is
weak.
But Z4muz wants the red instead.
So we've got a trade on the items. Oh, we've got a rail for a rocket. Oh, Z4muz almost getting a kill. How weak is Z4muz?
He has 18 health and 25 armor.
Oh my, they're pretty much even Stevens at this point. Z4muz trying to get onto the yellow.
One health for Z4muz.
Oh my, 50 health, 15 health for Empish, and that 50 HP bubble is not up. Even the 5 HP bubbles doubled his stacked in. Oh my god, the rail on the exit.
And he gets the red, but there's no health for him. Z4muz can just try to rush him off spawn, and in fact, it's probably what he's gonna do. How's Empish gonna try to defend himself from Z4muz's attack?
Well, he can't go full defense, because there's still 2 minutes
50
left.
Is there. Can Z4muz defend it? No, but he might get the Mega.
We've got a direct.
Z4muz missed 2 rocket jumps to get the Mega, and Empish missed the rail.
Oh, Z4muz has got to be ultra careful. There's going to be red up in a second. Is Empish going to put pressure on it? He's gone over to yellow. But Z4muz is on the other side of the map.
Yeah. It will be very stressing last 90 seconds for Z4muz, as he doesn't have anything. It would be better for him to even die now. He's on 30 health.
He's surviving right now, but as you said, it might be better just to give an extra frag to Empish.
As long as he does damage, but he didn't really do that much damage there, and Empish is going to be the one circling the yellows again. Everything's going to spawn right now. Can Z4muz take anything? He gets a rail, gets a red as well. He needs to connect with absolutely everything right now.
He hasn't been hit by a rocket yet, but here comes the lightning gun, pushing him, absolutely decimating him.
One more would be... No.
He won't hit it.
Mega's going to be up. Can Z4muz get the Mega up spawn? No, he doesn't even go for it.
This could be GG very soon. Empish doesn't go for it.
Z4muz going to take it, actually. 45 seconds. Z4muz can actually do something with this.
He needs to. He absolutely has to. He's got to get a kill in the next 15 seconds, or it's going to be lights out in map number one here. For Z4muz, there we are. He's got the red. He's out of ammo completely, so he cannot jump up. There is a box, but he's getting rails on him in the back.
He needs to just chase, and I'm not sure if he's comfortable enough in this map to do so. There comes Empish.
Empish is putting the pressure on now. He thinks he can end it right here. And in fact, with 15 seconds to go, Empish can breathe a sigh of relief here. and be happy knowing that he's won a very important map for him. This is map number one. It was Empish's pick, and this gives him good hopes in this best of five series. There we are, guys. GG, 12-8.
Well played, Empish.
Very well played, man. And do we know exactly what the map was next that was picked?
It's gonna be the M13, Lost World for Z4muz.
Okay, well, this surely will be very interesting. I'm just going to have to switch up the scores quickly.
And Z4muz is actually satisfied that he didn't lose 30-0.
Yeah. I did not see the chat then, but well, maybe he's going to be able to turn things around on DM13, because he's definitely, when I've seen him play DM13, he looks infinitely more comfortable. In fact, in his round one game, he played Toxicity first. He won something like 26-0, and in DM13, he won 30-0, or 32-0.
Oh, so that's 10 times better.
Basically, it's, yeah, essentially 10 times better. But we'll see, as these guys are going to be preparing for map number two in just a moment. Yeah, Z4muz is readied up, so we're going to get to it. Before we get into the game, got to remember that rocket frag from Empish in Toxicity. Amazing. But let's get into map number two, guys. Here it is, Empish versus Z4muz on Lost World. On Z4muz off the beginning once again, he's going to have the rocket spawn.
Good dodge on Empish there to get himself the rockets. He might get himself the LG as well, and Z4muz now knows that Empish should have the major weapons, and he's going to need to be very careful of when he wants to step into the middle map. Luckily for him, he already has a rocket, so his only concern is to get the LG.
Yeah, and he's sneaking his way over there, making sure that Empish hasn't spotted it. He hears it now, right above, and now
he
might change things up.
He's trying to plant a trap. This is going to be very risky. Can he plant
the
rocket?
Oh, he misses it. If he could have just nudged him in the back, then Empish would have fallen off, and it would have been very hard for him to connect to the following shots. But there are only four rockets to go. Make it three. Z4muz still got a couple of seconds left until Mega Spawns. But Empish isn't going to push any further. So I think that's actually fortunate for Z4muz. If he ran out of rockets there, Empish could have got a kill with the lightning gun.
He only has one rocket, though. And it's pretty superb. He's going to get an LG now, and now he should be starting to rain the middle map.
Yeah, this red, that's going to be his last port of call. And now he can do exactly that. And he wants to top up his LG ammunition, get the full 150 here. At plasma. Z4muz, you're missing grenades. I think you should pop down to the bottom again. But maybe not before this Mega Spawns. Oh, Empish moves up into middle of the map, and Z4muz just gets
a lot of that. Yeah, that was lot. 57% LG.
Wow.
On a very hard angle.
Oh, he tries to jump up. There's the rocket that meets him halfway. He's going to go for the yellow. Will he turn back and try and pick up red?
Empish just missed out on a great opportunity to steal the red himself.
Oh, what the hell just happened? They're just dancing all over each other. Z4muz doesn't go for the red. Empish takes it.
Yeah, I cannot believe that Empish actually managed to get the red after missing out on the first opportunity. A very awkward series of events there.
Oh, the lightning. Oh, my God. Z4muz hitting like a truck. And Empish, he's just terrified from that.
Yeah, I mean, everyone has to be terrified of Z4muz.
48% he hit there. And that wasn't, you know... He just got some solid tracking. Yeah, it wasn't like he was running forward at him and not strafing.
It's Z4muz. That's what we gotta be expecting. But Empish right now, he doesn't have much to work with. He has one yellow behind him and 100 health.
Oh dear,
and Z4muz has five times that.
Here it is, he's in middle map. He's gonna get caught up. This is gonna be first blood.
50% now.
Oh, here's the jump up. He's not going to chase him, though. He's going to go
down
to red.
That's a good decision, because if he chased, if he just chased directly, Empish could get an LG or just chase directly and, or just jump down directly and try to steal the red or the mega. This way, Z4muz maintains the control. And going on center map...
Empish, dodge! Please dodge! There's going to be more LG here, almost getting the third kill. God, 53% LG now.
That's Z4muz. Oh, no.
Oh, dear.
Okay, Empish, that's the best dodge I've ever. It's like, if I move to the lava, he cannot shoot the rocket on me. Oh, right.
Oh, the lava. All right, he wants to preserve his LG accuracy, I think. What's he? Oh, he's gone down to 52. Z4muz.
He should not use it anymore.
I do. Definitely see a kind of a complete change of confidence in Z4muz's play from
Toxicity
to
Lost
World.
Anymore.
Oh, the rocket at the end. It was a direct 4-1, and you can tell that Empish is struggling a bit now to keep his foot in this game. Oh, we got even a rocket jump. The LG coming out again, not hitting quite like it was before. Empish might get a kill. He's off the negatives.
Finally.
There's some good dodge this time. He managed to avoid almost certain death.
Yep, really good dodge and great rockets as well. But if he stays around this red, Zemuz might try to go to the mag. But obviously, Zemuz is thinking that Empish is actually in the mag. But he hears him there and he's going to steal the mag himself. But he doesn't have a rocket launcher, though. This is what Empish should capitalize on.
I think it's okay that Empish did that. He got the red completely unharmed. He's going to get a yellow now. And in fact, compared to what else he could have done, this is possibly as the most resources he would have got in that time frame. He's actually pushing out here, but two rockets are going to meet him in the hallway. And he is right back into the corridors.
Oh, and Zamas knows he's still there, and he's going to get the yellow and go back to the red. Such a good play by Zamas. Just making sure he gets everything, and Empish has nothing to
do. He can't protect
right
this mega. It's up in a couple of seconds.
He just needs to move away, because Zamas has the rotation going on. He's going to go to the other yellow. Actually, Zem is going to meet Empish right now. What can Empish do?
He's almost stuck. I want to see what Zamas. He's just using this moment to pick up a load of other items around the map.
Yeah, he's just well played. I mean, he does damage. Let's actually Empish pick
nice
up an LG fight. And
Empish hit really hard there, but he simply didn't have enough health and armor to, you know, carry on till the end of the fight where he could have possibly won.
Off again. Yeah, he did.
Empish? That wasn't... He didn't... There was no provocation there from Zamas for him to do that.
He was trying to dodge again, and he's like, yeah, lava.
Maybe his side strafe keys got jammed or something. comes
lava again. Oh my goodness, lava, stop getting frags.
It's hungry today. We don't usually see this many on lava kills on your average DM13 game.
Nope.
But it's a shame for Empish. He got off the negatives already. Now he's going to have to do it all over again. Here come the rockets, though, by the ammo crate. Not where you're going to want to be, but he didn't really have a choice then, as the rockets were kind of bouncing him where he didn't want to be. We've got the mega. No more rockets for Zamas, so he's going to have a hard time jumping up to the top level at any quick rate. Oh, there you go. He's got 139 ammunition, but he needs that extra 11. Shotgun actually working quite nicely, but
it's a TDM, it should work quite nicely.
He needed to hit a little bit more at the end to make it worth it, but now with 4 minutes to go and 9 frags between them, this has already gone into nightmare mode for Empish.
Yeah.
Zamas just needs to hold his cool over here, not make any ridiculous errors, and I think he's got map number 2 secured.
Should be.
And I believe it was Cure you said was picked as the third
one? Cure will be the third map, whereas Zamas will probably have a really hard time as he had in the first one.
I'm curious how many times he's actually played the map. So I know he's played it at least once against Yellowfish, who was his last opponent. But I don't know how many other times he may have played it.
Let's see. Cure... Oh my god. Around 2 times.
2 times.
Maybe 1.
Maybe 1.
Maybe only just that one.
Oh, mine.
That's gonna be hard.
Oh, well, nice little jump from Zamas. Managed to just about get onto the mega health before Empish could.
I mean, after seeing what Zamas can do on a map that he knows, I can only wish for him to practice.
Yeah.
Learn all of the maps.
He looks really solid over here. You know, and Empish is a good player in his own right. You can't take that away from him. This is a very convincing victory right now against, you know, definitely a player that I admire. Maybe Empish is just hoping there'd be air control. I'm not sure.
Oh, God.
Well, not into the lava this time. It's okay.
Yeah. I'm
facial.
Not sure if that's worse. Oh, my goodness. Stop hitting.
Empish going for the pummels. Is he going to jump to red? Well, he might have been heading that way, but he definitely did not arrive. Again, the rockets are just hitting constantly. He knows exactly where Empish is going to be when he's shooting those rockets to the upper level.
Lava.
Oh, dear. He's going to let him fall as well.
2. Wow.
It's quite significant. I think Empish, as long as he doesn't let this get to his head like that rocket, then he's got a great chance on Cure to pick up his second map victory. And did we see what was decided as the tiebreaker?
It's either Campgrounds or Furious Heights.
Okay. Because I actually think there's a good chance we could get to a tiebreaker.
I'm guessing Campgrounds.
Map number 4's got to be ZTN.
Yeah, it's Bloodrun.
Okay.
Or Zamas Peak.
So, I mean, it's all up to Empish, really, if he can do his duty on cure. Got a bit of LG out of range at the moment, just trying to finish him off at the end. Oh man, he's lost a 53 LG and he's gone down to 41.
Well, yeah, I know that put spam.
Oh, definitely. But I know that if that happened to you, you'd definitely had a sad you'd have a sad face at the end of your game.
I mean, after the 53%, I probably wouldn't use it anymore unless the guy was in jump pads.
Then he might be able to raise it just a tad more. But yeah, I mean, not really many other ways I can analyze this game. I don't know about yourself, Imps.
Empish got Zaymus with a little help from the lava.
I don't think we've ever said that on the stream before.
Nope.
And what would you say to Empish then if he were to play this again against Zaymus?
This map again?
Mm-hmm.
Stay away from lava.
Words of encouragement there from Imps.
He had a what was the start? Yeah, he had a good start, but then he started getting into the fights with Zaymus 1. Zaymus is very
LG, really.
Yeah, the LG fights, he just can't get in. And even the rocket, it's so hard. I mean, it's two weapons that Zaymus is really good with. He's also really good with the rail, but not as good as he is with the LG or the rockets.
Wow. Yeah. GG, guys. 16-2, as it turns out. And that is going to set us on a 1-1 scoreline here. Here in this best of 5 round 2 game. So it's actually turning out to be a pretty intense best of 5, although if Zaymus is able to do things like he just did on maybe map number 4 or even map number 3, then this could be shortened to just a 4 map series. But I liked what I saw from Empish on Toxicity. I want to see that again on Cure. I'm wondering what people in chat are thinking about this.
On Cure now.
Hmm.
And maybe even on Bloodrun or in the Tiebreaker map, because Empish really knows how to find those the damage with the rail, and in this map obviously doesn't have a rail.
Mm-hmm. Well, this next one, well, all the remaining maps we'll see will have a rail, but you know, I think Empish was going to know Bloodrun a fair bit. Does he know it as well as Zaymus? Not sure, but anyway, let's ignore Bloodrun for the time being because we are getting into game now on Cure, map number 3 here of this round 2 Swedish Championships of Quake Live match. And I'm going to actually follow Empish off the beginning of this one. It's his map and his time to shine. He doesn't actually go for the yellow despite spawning right next to it. He's going to get a couple shards and green armor and get the mega. And now he can try and go for the yellow, but Zaymus is right in front of him. But no damage really exchanged from either players.
And Zaymus is already picking up all of the major weapons. Empish still lacking that rail, but he's well positioned to defend his threat. There is Zaymus, and Zaymus is just not realizing what a trap that little room is.
It could have been a lot worse for him.
Yeah.
He got off light, I'd say.
No, definitely.
And Empish just waiting for this yellow. He might even get the shards below him. Yeah, he's seen. Definitely.
Oh, and Zaymus in the lava.
The lava?
Oh, God.
The transparent lava here. Empish all out of LG now. How much health does Zaymus have?
38 health, but he's gonna be rewarded with a red and 225, so he might try to defend the next yellow.
I think if Empish had a full load of LG, that full 150, then he might have even got the kill at the beginning then.
Yellow is up, and Empish is gonna collect it. Zaymus not around, I'm guessing he's trying to position himself at the red or checking out where Empish is. There he is.
Oh, he's up at the top. He's going to be dropping down to the lower areas. We've got some vertical LG here going from Empish. He doesn't have a rail, so he's looking for some splash. And Zaymus actually doesn't use the teleporter. When you don't know the maps very well, that's often a mistake you can do when you don't know exactly where the teleporter takes you to.
Yeah, the mistake that Empish is doing is not really paying that much attention to the item. Zaymus keeps getting all of the red, and Empish hasn't got the red yet. And the mag is gonna be up, and Empish needs to get
it's been up for some time now.
And in fact, Empish not even doing damage there. The red's gonna be up if he doesn't do damage at the red as well.
Wow, Empish. Zaymus takes
damage?
Everything.
Yeah,
I don't even think he hit
everything.
Him.
He did 20 damage, I think, with the rocket, and that's.
Oh,
it.
Yeah.
And now the L is gonna be up, and Empish is not really.
He needs the rail. He needs to get that rail right now. Look, he's just. Empish is probably wondering what the hell has just happened.
Yeah.
I swear I was taking items a second ago. And now Zaymus doing so much great rockets from Empish. Those were amazing.
Can he do this every time though? Because he's gonna need to start taking the items, and in fact, he's gonna encounter a rocket from. from Zamus. Okay. Yeah,
Zamus does have that red, and he's going to be delighted with his first frag, but he's going to need to work hard here to pick up this mega health, maybe unharmed. Yep, Empish looking for shotgun damage.
I love that jump from Zamus.
I guess when you got nothing else, Empish, then definitely worth it. He doesn't lose his life doing it. I think that if Empish maybe had a rail earlier, then it could have been a very different first minute and a half.
I think he's really nervous to actually get himself to pick up that rail. Good damage now again.
Oh yeah, Zamus.
Still 10 seconds for the red. He should go away, try to pick himself to 150. Mm-hmm. Let's see if Zamus will even show up at the red.
Well, there's the yellow. Who's picking up the red? It's going to be Empish, but here comes the lightning gun damage. He may have been trapped a little bit then. And Mega surely going to go over Zamus. Oh, the rail helping him over. And now he's going to return five. Misses the second. There's a 50 health bubble and some shards. So he's not available for the time being, but he's certainly not healthy by any means.
Empish only has 40 health, and he's actually chasing Zamus. And he's going
to
help him a lot.
Oh, he's right above him. Zamus not realizing it. He might edge away now. Happy with his 1-0 lead. Does not want to give that up just yet.
He just gave control to Empish. Can Empish do a better job on the items this time, though? He has a rail, so that should help him.
Definitely. And Zamus looks like he's just being careful. Doesn't want to give away a kill, but how long is he going to be able to run away from Empish on this map?
I mean, in this map, if you want to play that defensive game, you can, but you need to keep trying to do the damage and be aware of the items. And how is Zamus going to keep doing the damage if he doesn't know the rail angles that well? That's what I'm wondering.
And the yellow's up now. Is Empish near there? Oh, I can hear him in the distance, but he's not trying to block that item off from Zamus. So that's kind of Zamus's go-to area if he needs any. If he needs to refill his stack a little bit, then the yellow's for him.
And Empish just lets both items clash. The mag is going to be up now, and Empish taking his time to go to get there, and Zamus knows he could have rocket jump during the 5 seconds he was up, but he didn't want to do it. Just being as safe as possible, and great rails from Empish there.
Oh, I don't know if Zamus
needs to go away.
Again, that yellow is going to be up, but maybe Empish is going to be hot on his heels this time. Oh, he's coming up from the other side. Zamus didn't read the sounds correctly, and Empish can tie things up. It took him a while, but
the problem was that Zamus read the sounds a little bit too well, because Empish did a fake rocket jump when he was chasing him. Unfortunately, he missed the rocket jump, so that's why it turned out to be a fake one. And Zamus was just expecting him in the higher grounds.
Yeah, I mean, he was definitely looking that way, so... Well, he's got time still to rectify things, but he's dropped down maybe a little too early. Are we going to get the air rockets? Not this time round.
Zamus on 20 health.
This is going to be the lead here for Empish. Is he going to go for that red? So the megas, I mean, every big item is up on this map. Zamus, he's going to go for yellow. Is he going to rendezvous at the red? He does turn up over there. He's just rushed right in front of him, but Empish has cornered him with the rockets.
One
now.
That Zamus goes for the aggressive moves, because if he doesn't want to play the angles game and the damage game, as he doesn't know the map that well. Oh my, look at the LG from Zamus.
Three health left.
How did he just do that?
Is there any
I like
damage
this game.
Out?
I mean, if he goes a little bit more aggressive, Empish won't be expecting that, then Zamus same can actually carry him through this game.
Where Zamus went aggressive on the red before he died for the third time. I wish he carried on going, because if he kept on running, he would have picked up the red armor. Sure, he might have been trapped, but even the item denial there would have been, you know, very positive for him.
Let's see how's he gonna play it.
I think Empish
really
is looking down the bomb, but I think Zamus was actually going past the top. Well, maybe I'm reading the sound cues wrongly now.
Oh, Empish is nowhere near the red, and Zamus is gonna steal that one away. He's on 200 armor right now, and he might get the rail as well.
Yeah, this is a good chance for Zamus. I might have to switch over to him briefly, have a look.
Mega in a second.
Oh, Empish has been found, but takes barely any damage. Zamus, though, he's looking over at the Mega. If he can win this one, it could be a big change in the pace of this match.
Yeah, now Zamus says no. Zamus actually goes for the red. That's interesting, because he would benefit from the Mega much more, but wouldn't be that much safer.
Oh, there's the direct rocket. He needed to hear that thud. Now going over the lightning gun, he picks up the kill before Empish goes through the teleporter.
Yeah, his aim is on fire right now. He's gonna pick up the yellow, get back over to the red, and if Empish is wandering around there, he needs to get away.
Ooh,
great rail by Empish.
Awesome angle. Something that Zamas might not be expecting. He takes a nasty rocket over here. Has to escape.
His
rockets are not hitting, and Empish is hitting everything.
Yeah, Empish is doing a lot of damage. And is even going to deny the 50 health from Zamas. He's going to find him there.
Whoa, that rail.
Zamas is the one connecting.
Mega's up. Empish never went for it. And we got the rocket jump over. Oh, no.
You just need to do two basic strafes, Zamas. There we go.
It kind of works at last. And as she reds up, is Zamas going to be able to get it? He absolutely will be able to. And I think Empish could have stolen it if he desired.
Yeah, I mean, Empish was... Oh, God, he needs to get away.
What a surprise.
He was the one doing the most safe move there because he knew both of them were on the same health, but he would benefit nothing if
this.
He lost there. Oh, my God, he's going to drop on him. This should be a frag.
There's the lightning gun. Good rocket from Empish at the end. Zamas, though, ties things up with 90 seconds to go. Red is going to spawn in time for him. Empish has managed to pick up a yellow. Let's see if the battle will ensue over at the mega health. 8 health left for Zamas.
He needs to get away. If he dies right now, this could be a good game for Empish.
But, I mean,
Empish is even looking
health.
For the double back.
Look what's Empish doing? Look, he's got tons of health. And
yeah, Zamas has nothing right now.
What's he going to do? Is he going to look over at Red? Where's
Empish?
Red
is up. Empish?
Oh,
Empish.
There it is.
The frag and Empish. 200-100 right now. This is going to be so, so hard for Zamas.
He's found it though, direct rocket. Can he get any more? Getting half this one takes him down to 50 health.
All he needs is to rush Empish right now, and he spawns in the LG. This could help a lot.
He's gonna He's surely gonna go for it.
He thinks the red's gonna be up right now, but it's going to take a while. Empish is well positioned, and this could be the next frag for Empish.
Yeah, if there's a frag right here, then it is gonna be lights out for Zamas on map number 3, but he's taking Empish down to 26 health. Is he gonna follow from the bottom half? No, he's right up above, in fact. It might be a race over to the yellow armor. Zamas has got to get the kill in the next 5 or so seconds. He's pushing through aggressively, but there are the rockets. Empish has defended map number 3, and he's going to be putting himself on match point moving into ZTN. Nice work there by Empish. Zamas almost had it. I think really that moment where Zamas had 8 health, he kind of just like... He was almost paralyzed. He didn't know exactly what to do then.
Yeah, I mean, I think probably the best choice would actually be to kill himself there.
Mm-hmm.
And just start over, because with 4 health, with 8 health, he just let Empish pick up everything. And if he just killed himself, got a weapon, he could actually try to challenge for an item next. But obviously that's a great risk, and he would have to chase for the lead again.
Yeah, certainly. It would have been hard work. Actually, no matter what happened, it would have been hard work. If as you said, if he died earlier, maybe if he just ran at Empish during that fight they had in the lower corridor, then maybe he could have got a little bit more damage going, and then, as you said, the chance to go and pick up some more items more immediately. But we are going to be moving over to Blood Run, which is map number 4, and as I said, match point for Empish. Very curious to see if Empish can pull this one off, because it would be... a big win for him, and I think a big upset in the tournament. Despite already knowing that Zamas has been very inactive, I think people are still expecting Zamas to not, I wouldn't say go the distance in the tournament, but to go to the finals, the main event.
Well, the thing is, even with not knowing the newer maps, he could definitely do it.
Yeah, well, let's have a look here in map number 4. We are on Blood Run, and I will watch Zamas off the start of this one. He's going to be getting top yellow straight onto that red armor. It's going to be even split here off the beginning. Now it's just a race to see who can get those weapons as quick as possible and position themselves.
Empish already has all of the major weapons. Oh my goodness, and he also has
150 damage right in your head. Zamas is just waiting here patiently. If Empish goes for this jump to red armor, this could be first blood pretty early. There's the spawn.
Yes,
there's the
goes.
Trap. Oh, the rocket afterwards as well, trying to finish the job off. Going for the 25 health bubble, but Empish held his movement for a second.
Such a huge risk from Empish to actually go there. He knew that Zamas didn't have the LG, but Zamas still had much more stack than Empish had.
I like the trap though. Great work from Zamas, but now he might have to forfeit this next red armor just so he can get this LG.
Empish is, however, taking surprising long amount of time to take it. Great trail by Z4muz. See what he will do now. Mega is up in 5 seconds, so Z4muz is just perfectly positioned to take the Mega, as he doesn't really need to take the red because he has more yellow armors waiting for him.
For a bit of LG at the end, Empish cannot hit another rail.
There's a Mega for Z4muz.
He's got the Mega, he might be able to make an aggressive push onto this red armor. He goes up to the yellow, jump up to the top. Empish has already taken red, they're going to meet each other in the hallway. This is dangerous, but Z4muz goes to the bottom of the pit. And they're going to have to break away from each other.
Yeah, Z4muz didn't go to the 50 HP, to the teleporter, as soon as he saw Empish going to the top yellow, so he knows that Empish has almost 100 health and 50 armor right now. Doesn't connect to the rail, that's going to be unfortunate.
Oh, here's one.
Great rail now, and he's well positioned. He doesn't even need to take the red first, but he's going to have to do it fast. There we go.
Slightly risky, I'd say, but he manages to make it work. We've got the mega health. Oh, and the rail at the end! Empish was vulnerable. And he definitely suffered at this point. We got first blood spilled. There's a bit of time now until the following item. Z4muz surely going to be looking good to pick up this next red armor. Or maybe he's going to be going after the damage again, you know? He seems to be already happy to set up some traps, but Empish pushes himself onto the rocket launcher and pays the price.
Such collective accuracy there.
Oh, Empish, he didn't get the rocket, he only had the rail, and that maybe would have hindered his chances.
Empish didn't connect with the rail yet, he fired the 11 already.
Oh, that line of gun, and the rail at the end.
He's so collected in the way that he shoots, he's so comfortable between the rails. He's gonna miss out on the Mega though. It's up, and Empish is gonna go there and steal it himself.
Is Z4muz gonna try and set up another trap though? I kinda getting the feeling that there's a catch to it. Empish might have Mega, but what else is gonna happen? Z4muz is trying to go for the yellow, but it's not spawned just yet. And it actually makes it out just in the nick of time.
Yeah, not going through the Mega there turns out to be a mistake from Z4muz, as Empish now has a chance to push for the control. Z4muz actually goes away, takes the defensive route. And is Empish gonna go ahead and steal the red?
Yeah, he does.
There
he
goes. And Z4muz will have no idea when it was taken. He knows that the Mega is up, and Empish is really late to appear there.
Is Empish gonna keep on pushing? He eventually moves past after Z4muz is able to do any damage, but he wasn't able to really return any himself. And it's just bits of splash here being exchanged. There we are, the Empish going through the teleport. He's now taken two rails. He's going to be pretty weak, but it's a magnificent rocket from himself.
Well, he's on 20 collective health.
Oh dear. Z4muz isn't really tanked though, I'd say, at this point, but he's going to be tanked enough to get that red.
He does move like a tank though. It's like him and Tox, they have such similar movement.
I think he uses Tank Junior as his model.
No, he uses Tank Major.
Good work there from Z4muz. Empish kinda just walking into him at that point. Wrong place at the wrong time. There's a nice little flick at the end.
I wish I could shoot rail like that.
Let's see how he said. He's hitting 64% rail.
Yeah, and Empish has fired the same amount and is hitting 0%.
Really? Oh dear, oh dear. I think what we've seen though from Z4muz today already is we've seen some great LG, we've seen great rockets, and great rail. Now I'm wondering if he can combine all three of those into one map. And he might need to do that on the fifth one if he wants to push himself through to round three.
Yeah, I mean, the fifth one, whether it is Furious Heist or Campgrounds, both of them will know it really, really well. Mm-hmm. For Z4muz's sake, I hope it's Campgrounds, though.
I think he's surely be able to play both, I reckon. Oh, here we are, LG eventually connects. It's going to be 7-0 now.
Z4muz went to the finals at DreamHack 2011 with Avec. That was back in the time where T9 was still in the competitive pool.
Yeah. Well, certainly he played quite a bit of Quake Live at the beginning. Yeah, I mean, he's played quite a bit of Quake Live at the beginning of it, at least. So yeah. He will have certainly practiced Furious Heights. But he obviously will have played a lot more Campgrounds, because obviously it's been around for a lot longer. Oh, looking for the optimistic air rockets. Why not? And really, again, much like it was in Lost World, Z4muz has just gotta, you know, keep his cool. Don't throw anything, don't make too many errors. And, yeah, I mean, hold steady for another 4 minutes. And it's gonna be red up in a second. Is Z4muz gonna be giving this one away? It's up right now, but in fact, Empish, he decides he wants to push in a little bit more aggressively.
Well, he's trying to actually get on the scoreboard, because on the first map that Z4muz picked, he couldn't even get out of the negatives.
I mean, he got a frag, but he didn't
get
on the scoreboard, essentially. And now he hasn't at all. At least there's no lava here, I guess.
Unless you can find it.
I don't think you can fit in there.
There is lava on campground. Oh, he finds Z4muz.
Alright, our little air rocket, and he's got enough splash damage at the end, but Z4muz was phenomenally weak. He needs to find some health bubbles. And Empish just sitting up at the top. Gonna be a tough angle for Z4muz to hit. But he's, you know, Mega's gonna be up next. He's in good position for this. And Empish really is having a hard time unlocking the items for himself. Actually, tell us what the control is like between these two.
It's fairly similar. I mean, Empish got a couple more yellow armors, but a couple less reds and half the magas.
Oh no. Not where you want to get caught out. Oh, I thought we were going to see more direct rockets then.
The damage, though, is just 1,000 more damage for Z4muz, and you can see that in the kills.
Mm-hmm.
He's getting much more rocket damage. And the rails, obviously, as Empish only hit one rail out of 18.
18! One out of 18.
That's 5% for the low fly player.
Oh, wow. He'll be very mad at himself for that.
Yeah.
But it's not something he can linger on. He's going to have to focus himself on the rest of this map, and of course, importantly...
There we go. Two out of 19 now. 10%. That's 1% better than Matrox. Oh, now he's exploding.
Yeah, he's coming into his own at this point.
Can he get 9 frags in less than 2 minutes, though?
Well, maybe that'll be a bit more debatable. I think Z4muz just got that mega health. As I was saying earlier, I mean, Empish, he's got to focus as much as he can on this map, and importantly, because it looks very much like we're going to be going to a tiebreaker, he's got to be focused on that fifth map. And you could say the same for Z4muz, I guess. Good direct here from Empish. Has he got enough to get a kill? He does.
There we go.
And this is the kind of thing that's definitely going to make him feel good, getting some kills at the end of this. It's a good boost to your confidence.
He's getting a lot of kills. Oh, the mech is gonna be up now, and he doesn't go for it.
It's alright though, with 60 seconds left. Empish knows that there's little to no chance of making this comeback. Let's have a look. Yeah, Z4muz, near enough 50% rel towards the end of this. And I'm gonna just have a quick look at the scoreboards, and we're gonna get to see it in, towards the end anyway. Yeah, you guys can see the item control and the damage on there. Empish racking up a bit more damage towards the end. Well, GG's will surely be called very soon. And guys, if you are enjoying the show and the tournament, go check out quakesm.sc. That's where all the information regarding the tournament is. The main event finals, the top number one player of each group will be attending, or at least partially attending, the Stockholm Esports Arena to play their final games. So a very cool event we got ourselves here. GG, guys, 13-4 in favor of Z4muz, and that is going to be tiebreaker map for us on our first game of the day.
I wonder what map it is. I would like to see both maps.
You want to see both? I don't know if we're allowed that, man. Unfortunately, we're only allowed
Furious
one more
Browns.
Map from Z4muz this week. Furious
Camp Heights.
I think I prefer Furious Grounds, but I'm not sure, to be honest.
I would be a mix of both of them.
We don't know. It's going to be Campgrounds, man.
Oh.
I don't know if this, because I think it was Empish last to pick. I'm not sure.
No, it was Z4muz's pick.
Oh, was it? Okay.
Yeah, Empish dropped Sinister.
Really? He dropped Sinister? Even if Empish had never played Sinister before, I think he would have a better chance on Sinister than he would on Campgrounds.
Definitely. I mean, dropping Campgrounds there.
I think that's a big blunder for Empish. But we'll see if this pays off for him or if it doesn't.
Thing is, he would still have to play the Furious Heights or Campgrounds. But if he dropped Campgrounds, he would have to play Furious Heights, and maybe he'd feel more comfortable there.
I don't know which map he would be more comfortable. Obviously, he's more comfortable on Furious Heights and Campgrounds, but I think he has maybe should have taken more into consideration his opponent's skills rather than his own. Because, Zamas, we know, is not confident on new maps at all. Very unstable, and even from what we've seen on Toxicity, and which isn't even that new anymore, and Cure, certainly room for Empish to do some damage on Sinister. But Campgrounds here, and these guys are going to be readying up very shortly. We can have a quick look-see on the game screen. See, as they're warming up at the moment. And there's no Aerowalk in the pool, so I've just been told. Make sure they don't pick Aerowalk, because it's not in the pool, remember?
Yeah.
So we won't be getting any of that during this tournament. And of course, guys, if you have been enjoying the casts as well, do hit the follow button on Twitch. Enjoy any kind of support we get from you guys. If you do follow on Twitch, you get notified via email or Twitch messages whenever we go online. Well, I'm not sure if Twitch messages or if there's some kind of dashboard on your side that will notify you when we're live. But we're going to be live all week from 1800 Central European time till around 2000, 2100. So, and we're going to be doing the Swedish Championships all week. So lots of stuff there. Catch the VODs as well on our Twitch or our YouTube. Lots of information you can scroll down on and see below the video frame itself. Looks like Empish is just holding his horses for a moment.
He requested ready for a couple of minutes.
I see.
Five.
Well, hopefully he's preparing something magical for us then. Maybe.
Maybe. He's preparing another cake to be delivered to you.
I want that cake, man. Did you see the cake?
Yeah, it's a sheep cake.
It looked awesome.
Did you see that kind of knife with it.
Well, man, it had like lots of little sort of white chocolatey flakes. I like white chocolate. And it just, yeah. Sorry, I'm salivating, but maybe I'll get distracted by these guys when they ready up. But maybe Empish is just chilling out a bit. We know some players who just, like, after a game or two, they know, okay, this is intense. I need to have a cigarette to get ready or something like that.
Like all the Russian community.
Master saying, DM6 for reals, this is better than Christmas and DreamHack on the same day. I wonder, is this going to be the last time we're going to see Zamas play competitively? Or is this going to be the beginning, essentially, of his run through this week?
I don't know. I mean, he just does it from time to time. He comes in, he plays for a couple of months, then he starts going to those techno music festivals and stops Quake for a couple of months, then comes back.
Yeah. Well, hopefully no distractions here. I'm going to be at the Stockholm Esports Arena. It'd be really cool if we could get Zamas to go over or whichever of the players who make it through, because it's definitely not guaranteed at the moment that Zamas is going to go through, especially even if he does win against Empish. There's still Juro lurking around the corner. That's a very troublesome opponent. But it'd be very cool to have some of the top tier players there. We could get some interviews, maybe get some casting and stuff. I mean, we still got to organize exactly how all of that's working. But yeah, hopefully there's going to be lots of interesting content January 2014 for Quake Live, as people are also waiting for 125 FPS to come to its revival, which has been rumored is happening in February, but I've had no real confirmation as far as I know. I'll let them do their announcement if there indeed is one. And I've heard that Deadlift versus Smurfy is going to be the next map. The next game that we're going to be going to. So I guess Zoro hasn't turned up yet. Which is a shame. I hope that we get to see Zaki versus Zoro today, because actually those are some very talented individuals. The next match between Smurfy and Deadlift, I can't say I know a huge amount about either of those players.
Well, Smurfy is a 1900 yellow player. His top 5 is around the 2200 yellow mark. 2000 elo mark, and Deadlift has 1700 elo.
Mm-hmm.
So however, his top 5 goes from 2.4k to 1.9k.
I see. So an interesting range that we've got on his. I'd say it sounds like deadlift then is going to be the underdog going into that game.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, maybe something very interesting for our next matchup here. And it looks like Empish has returned. He's moving around, and we should hopefully be getting those ready ups momentarily. I'm not sure what to predict here at all. I don't know if this is going to share the similar kind of pace that we've been getting on Lost World or ZTN, or if we're going to get a similarly close match as on Toxicity or Cure, but we are about to find out as they have readied up. Winner of this match is going to go through to round three next week. Z4muz and Empish, and I'm going to be on Empish right off the beginning.
God.
Oh, Z4muz got the LG first. I thought Empish had it.
That's the worst spawn you can possibly have on campground. There's like a 5% chance that those two spawns happening.
That is
and it had
nasty.
To be now against Empish. Luckily for him, he got the yellow and he has a rail. And he's trapping, so to speak. There. He actually hits the rail, but he cannot go. Oh my god, he hits another one.
Is there any more? What else
he's
has
making
got for
the
us?
Best of the awful spawn he had.
And Z4muz, I think, moved around to go for red. Yep, he's not forgetting about that. He might be able to pick up a Mega as
oh
well. Awesome
god.
Rocket there by Empish.
Empish, that was. He's doing really, really well with what he was given.
Oh, totally. He looks like he's actually very calm and collected on this. And he's not mindlessly rushing, which is sometimes what you feel like doing when you get a spawn like that. But this time he's moving in onto the bridge. Red's going to be spawning behind him in a second. He's got to be careful because a good flicker of lightning here could take him out. Manages to escape unkilled.
Already, Z4muz going to come to the yellow. No, but Empish hits the rail himself.
How much damage has Z4muz done yet so far?
217 with that rail now.
Empish has done a fair amount, I think. Ooh, almost hitting the rail at the end. But it looks like Empish is just going to try and cycle on these yellow armors and see if he can build some kind of stack from this and maybe the shards down the bottom.
Yeah, I mean, right now he's pretty much hoping for Z4muz not to make... to make mistakes on the items.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, but Z4muz coming in. In fact, he's going to plant a trap onto Empish. And Empish actually gets away with not too much damage taken. It's fairly good for him. He can try to go and go to the red himself, as Z4muz is still here. Does he actually know?
Means he'd have to go to the other side, and that might be difficult. Z4muz gets on Mega and moves out.
Yeah, but Empish is going to check out the timing, though. There he goes. He has timing on Mega and Red. However, he does not have...
Red's not been taken yet.
Oh, so maybe Empish won't have exact timing on the red.
And Z4muz now moves over to the yellow armor. Empish misses out on his drop, but nice that Empish wasn't over at the yellow this time.
Yeah, thing is, Z4muz is going to be a little bit more aggressive now, and he's going to push in for a kill. There it is, the kill now.
It happened. Z4muz waited for the right time, didn't want to take too much damage, and that was the opportunity he chose.
However, Empish can try and steal the red, because it's still up, and can he actually do it? He's going to drop. No. Oh,
he tries to. The rocket jump turned out to be the perfect choice from Z4muz. And we got ourselves a 2-0. He might rush this yellow armor. Oh, he just spots a possible rail angle there, but he doesn't want to chase up the bounce pad, and Empish is able to get away.
Let's see what is Empish going to try to do. Z4muz sees it there, and he doesn't even gonna let Empish take that rocket.
Oh, this is gonna be close. Actually, Z4muz survives at 38 health. We've got
this
that
is good
red
for
spawning.
Empish though. He's gonna get the LG spawn. He can protect this Mega. He can defend it, and in fact, he does. Can he get away without taking more damage from Z4muz? He does. Z4muz doesn't chase for him.
Z4muz actually not super stacked right now. I'd say Empish is ahead.
He is, definitely is ahead. Oh, and the rocket doing little bits of damage. Is he going to push Z4muz now? Z4muz, that's a very good decision. Taking the top position now, he can actually try to do damage at red without taking much.
Z4muz surely won't drop. That would be suicidal. And there it is. Empish eventually makes his move onto it. Z4muz escapes. He's got to hit those rails.
A lot of ammo though. He ran out of rockets. You'd like to make a rocket jump. Now he's going to have to take the rockets himself. Maybe try to get onto the rail. Z4muz going to be around though. Oh, he misses it.
Oh, dude, but Empish doesn't go for it. He goes for the aggressive move and it's going to be a kill.
Amazing.
Empish makes it happen. What
a
dummy.
Really good turn out of events for Empish.
And Z4muz actually being aggressive on this red armor. He's doing damage.
Yeah, but that's not really the best decision because now Empish... Oh, he doesn't get the frag, but he can go and take the yellow as Z4muz probably is a little bit concerned about the rail now. But Empish didn't go for the yellow, so it means he needs to defend his Mega with the stack he has, and Z4muz just got position on it. and Empish is forced to move away.
Will he get this red? I'm nervous for him that he won't. Look, he's hiding in the stairwell. And Samus drops down and Empish is like, phew, I'm safe for at least a fraction of a second.
Well, safe for now.
Yeah. Whoa. Rail Angle's coming out. And Empish count himself lucky right there. He didn't get shot before picking up that yellow. But he's surviving, man. And he's brought it one frag closer.
Yep, he needs to do what he did again. Next couple of minutes. Mag is going to be up after, but taking the stairs there. Oh, he goes back away. But he's going to let Z4muz pick up the Mega. And the red.
I can see why Empish picked this map, because his decision making is very interesting. The way he doubles back into fights.
Not even a veteran as Z4muz is managing to read him perfectly.
Yeah.
In fact, can he defend red? Nope. He's gonna move away. But it's very interesting because he always leaves himself with the decision to. If Z4muz makes a mistake, Z4muz knows he needs to be on his toes. Because if he makes a mistake on the items, Empish is going to be there to steal it. And Empish is always well positioned to give himself escape routes if Z4muz doesn't make the mistake.
I'm currently empathizing quite a lot of Empish because it just seems so tense watching him right now. The thing is,
he's in the red.
In terms of survival, he's making some beautiful decisions. He can't get onto red armor. The LG is too strong.
Yeah, that was a really good opportunity, though.
If he was on the red, or if he just sat on the spawn, then he might have been able to actually survive and potentially change that fight around. Two great rails we just saw from Z4muz. Is he going to be able to capitalize on this and maybe extend that frag lead more?
I'm guessing Empish is on 50 health.
And he's probably weak.
Because he took two rails. Probably got 225s there, but... Let's see if Z4muz is going to rocket jump.
He can hear the LG buzzing. Surely. Or is that just his own? I'm not sure. Maybe I'm hearing things.
No, Empish was there, and in fact, he got the red timing as well.
The thing is, he didn't get the red, nor did he get the yellow. And nor will he probably get this mega hit, because he's going to be dying, in fact. And Z4muz is actually looking to find a kill, but he actually rocket jumps, come back down for that mega health.
Really good damage from Empish, and look how he moves away as Z4muz wants to reply.
Just exactly minimizing any damage he receives. But here it is, Z4muz, interesting jump through there. I think he was slightly propelled by the rocket.
Oh, that's gonna be a frag. Yeah. Empish needs to be way faster if you wanted to get this yellow.
Did he rocket jump up the bounce pad?
No.
He went extremely high then. Oh, almost the air rockets. Empish has already provided us with some amazing action with his rockets. But maybe not coming when the time is needed. Alright, here it is. Move up the bounce pad. Oh. There's an air rocket. Almost a follow-up we're getting. 8-1.
Yeah.
It's just really, for show.
It's going to be so hard for Empish to actually do anything now. But so far, a really good game. Unfortunately for him, Z4muz didn't really make mistakes.
Yeah, on DM6, Z4muz was really stable. And you know what? Empish, for 6 minutes maybe, was giving us an awesome campgrounds. And now I think he's getting a little bit impatient and knows that it's a bit urgent.
Unless he gets a really lucky kill, and even then he needs to just get spawn frag after spawn frag.
And hope that somewhere in between that, control would be acquired. And, well, it just didn't happen, so we've got sub 2 minutes to go. And we could be about to see Z4muz taking down this best of five in round two. And this is a solid victory for him, and I'm very curious how he's going to be feeling moving into the next round. Remember, guys, if he wins round three, then he's going to be a part of the main event. That's going to be on the 25th of January. A little bit of LG, just a tickle right at the end. 52% rail, 29% LG. How's Empish's rail doing now?
36%.
That's a big improvement on Blood Run.
Yeah, after 10%, anything's gonna be an improvement.
Pretty much. I mean, what do you think really went wrong for Empish in the end? Because he made some nice moves, he was doing some good interesting double backs and aggressive attacks.
Yes, I mean, thing is, he was relying on Zamas to actually make a mistake. He waited 6 minutes for Zamas to make a mistake, and Zamas didn't, and Empish couldn't really push Zamas into making mistakes unless going for a really risky situation. So it was either going for that red and hoping to pick it, or going to even more risky fights, hoping to make a lot of damage. I think he made the best of what he had.
You know, when he did get his first frag, when the score was 1-3, I think he was left pretty weak after, or maybe there was a fight after that that put him extremely weak, and that seemed to be it. That seemed to kind of tranquilize his comeback completely. So definitely some opportunities there, and you know, hopefully for people watching, there's going to be some newfound love for Empish as well, because he's given us a fantastic series. But of course, the credit's going to Zamas here, winning 15-1 on campgrounds and taking the series 3-2. Very, very well played. That was interesting. I wasn't actually expecting a full 5 maps. I don't know what I was expecting, but I'm very pleased at what I just saw, man. We just saw Zamas playing competitively, and I think that is pretty hype. Sorry, I again have been watching too many speed running things and fighting.